this slayed me. I was fairly certain I was going to love this film. The original is one of my all-time favourites. It was the same production team being allowed to work their magic again, and the early buzz was wildly positive. But I loved this story so much, had such a deep connection with the characters, that when I emerged into the sunshine to discover that people had problems, it was baffling and saddening. Because the bittersweet weight of this is impossible not to feel for me. From Mr. Blue Sky onwards, I was just incredibly happy to be back with these guys. And as the credits rolled, I was already thinking about how long it was going to be until we get to hang out together, outside of a support appearance in the already stuffed to the gills Avengers Infinity duology. Guardians 3 hasn't even been announced yet, although its existence is assured. The strengths of this film lie with the amount of time that Gunn and company allow you to just kick back and spend with the Guardians in compromising situations that bring their weaknesses and misgivings to the surface. I deeply appreciated the more leisurely pace, the lack of prerogative to prevent a universe-ending cataclysm, something economically afforded to just one section to explain and then deal with. They have to be the Guardians of the Galaxy, after all. But here's the big one. Looking for something and finding that you've had it all along isn't new. As I said, the fact that he's looking for his father is a nice way of exemplifying multiple generations who have not had that sense of stability of a man that they can depend on. I myself have historically had trouble there. But I haven't been looking for a father so much as I've been looking for a teacher. When I was in my teens, I was looking for a Morpheus, soon after that a Gandalf, also a Dumbledore, a sage. I want someone who believes in me to take me under their wing, change my perspective, smack me up sharply, shake out my bad habits, send me out into the world again, having learned a valuable lesson. That's what I'm searching for. An older authority figure who recognizes what I can do is potentially valuable to the world and wants to help me to do what I do, only better. I've waited, and I've searched, and I've adopted a few who might fit this bill, and I've always found myself disappointed as they lost interest and faded away. Until the point where I reached the conclusion that this Gandalf is not going to appear, that he was inside me all the time, that I've had to teach myself so much over the years in absence of a teacher, that it's my prerogative to help others, to believe in them, to take them under my wing, to change their perspective, to smack them up sharply, to shake out their bad habits, to send them out into the world, having learned a valuable lesson. At least that's how I felt going into Guardians 2. But the reason this rocketed to the top of my Marvel movies favourites, and thus my favourite films of all time list, was the realisation that I did, in fact, meet my Gandalf many years ago. And he stayed with me. Or rather, she did. Because you see, Sharon was the one who came along when I was 19, having just seen The Matrix. My mind was wide open. She believed in me then. And she altered my perspectives, she broadened my vision, she made me sharpen up my skills and compelled me to work harder than I ever thought I could at what I'm good at. She's been my sage all along, my teacher, and it's so bloody obvious that even my subconscious brain knows it. Last year, when I was writing The Princess Thieves, I deliberately gender-flipped the Merlin character, modelling her partly on Granny Weatherwax, who was, in effect, Sharon's Gandalf growing up, and giving her affectations of Sharon. Before I met her, I was rude, obnoxious, bright, lazy, and a teenager through and through. All the best of me today is the direct result of Sharon's guidance, insight, teachings, and faith in my ability. So, as Peter... excuse me, guys. As Peter Quill realized... God, just get through this last paragraph, dude. So, as Peter Quill realized that the father he had always yearned to spend time with was someone he had placed in the wrong box his whole life, I realized that Sharon had been occupying the apparently empty sage box for me all of these years, as well as the one marked wife and the one marked best friend. So thank you, Sharon. I've been waiting for weeks to say that. Like, that was my thought coming out of Guardians, and I was like, right, now when can we podcast on it? Because I've really got to be able to get this into words. And thank you to James Gunn and company for smacking me up sharply with this profound realization. All the times that I've cried, keeping all the things I knew inside, it's hard, but it's harder to ignore it. If they were right, I'd agree, but it's them they know.
and I know that I have to go away. I know I have to go.
You guys still there?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thanks for making sure we have to follow that.
I'm sorry.
Thank you for making sure I'm not going to be able to say anything for the rest of the show.
You're welcome.